Well, gentlemen, thanks for stopping by the studio here today to talk about the start of the legislative session that's next week. Mr. Vander Linden, I'll start with you. What's the top priority for the Iowa House this year?
Well, I think the top priority is to get out of town. If what I'm hearing from the leadership is turns out to be correct, we're expecting it to be a relatively short session. I think the general thinking is that there was a lot of heavy lifting was done last year, and so that this will be a relatively quiet session. That said, I won't be surprised if there's some surprises, because there's always something comes out of the woodwork. So we'll see.
And Mr. Rozenboom, yes. Tell me a little bit about what the top priority is for the Senate this year.
Well, since we're in the minority, I don't know if I can address what the top priority of what the majority party is, but I agree with what Guy said. By all accounts, it's going to be a rather short session. There was a lot of heavy lifting done last year. I'm sure there will be some tweaking that has to be done with education reform, with perhaps property tax reform, but more importantly, maybe the mental health redesign. I believe that's a work in process, and it's going to continue to go for a while yet. So there's going to be a lot of work on some of that those things, I believe.
And let's talk about individual goals. What are some of the things you're looking forward to working on? Guy, we'll start with you.
Well, as chairman of the State Government Committee, of course, I'm primarily focused on election issues, to a lesser extent, gambling, licensing, some of those things that come before our committee. There are two bills that are of particular interest to me. One would move school board elections from September to November. And the other one would be to have runoff elections in the case where somebody doesn't get at least 35% of the vote. That now goes to the parties decide who wins. There is a bill that would make that a runoff election. So that's a couple of the bills that I'm particularly interested in seeing come before us.
And Mr. Rozenboom.
Well, I have a couple real boring pieces of legislation I'm working on. It has to do with rural improvement zones and with time of transfer legislation. Nothing exciting there, but they're both concerns for people in my constituency. And beyond that, as a member of the Natural Resources and Environment Committee, I'm anxious to move forward on our nutrient reduction strategy that was initiated last year. I know the Secretary of Agriculture has requested some additional funding for that, so I'm also the ranking member of the Agriculture and Natural Resources Appropriations Committee. So in that role, I'll be watching funding on that. And then in a broader scope, I'm on the Appropriations Committee. So we're always going to have battles on how much money we're going to spend as a state and how we're going to spend it. So I would guess when the dust settles at the end of the session, that will have been one of the things that potentially could keep us around longer than people want to stay, and will probably be somewhat contentious.
When it comes to taxes, what can people expect to be seen done with that? Mr. Rozenboom, we'll start with you.
Well, property tax reform last year was, by all accounts, a huge improvement, and most people aren't going to see a lot of change on that. But over the 10-year period where this is implemented, I think it's going to help property or business owners in a fairly significant way. Senate Republicans will continue to work on reducing or even eliminating income tax. Now, that's a long-term goal. I don't know what, if any, progress we'll make this year, but it's certainly, as Guy and I are both very conservative with taxpayers' money, we think that's something that we need to continue to keep at the forefront, is to reduce the tax burden on Iowans.
Mm-hmm. And Guy over in the House?
Well, I'm on the Ways and Means Committee, so I get to see the tax legislation that starts fairly early in the process. I'm hoping we can do something about income tax. As Senator Rozenboom suggests, we did some pretty big things with property tax last year, so I doubt that we will be able to tweak that very much. Overall, House Republicans have tried to spend less than we take in, and we've been pretty successful at that so far. So I'm anxious to continue that. I hope we can even reduce the tax burden, the overall tax burden on Iowans, but we'll see. Income tax will be the first thing that comes up, I think.
As you've been off these past couple of months, you're still nonetheless working as you speak with your constituents. What are some of the things that you're hearing from your constituents? Guy, I'll start with you.
Well, many of the same subjects we've already discussed. Taxes is always an issue with folks. Education is always an issue with folks. As Senator Rozenboom suggests, this mental health reorganization is certainly a work in progress, and I hear from folks about all three of those things.
And speaking of mental health reorganization, right now Mahaska County is in the process of trying to form a region with Marion County, and that's just two counties then, Mahaska and Marion. And I believe the state has asked regionalization with three contiguous counties. What's the likelihood of Mahaska County being able to partner with just one other county and being a two county?
I'll address that because I've been, as a county supervisor, was part of the initial process to join or form a region. We were actually, along with Marion, Jasper, and Poweshiek counties, the first region to sign a letter of intent to form a region. Over time, that letter of intent was not acted on by DHS, and over time, and here's where I've lost track because I'm not in the supervisor's chair anymore, Poweshiek and Jasper chose to join with other counties. That left Marion and Mahaska kind of on an island alone. And I joined with supervisors from Mahaska and Marion counties about a month ago to meet with Director Palmer at DHS to ask for a waiver on that three-county requirement. The two counties can provide all the core services that are required by the legislation, and in fact can provide even beyond that. I think going forward there may be more requirements, and I believe the two counties can handle those. So I've not heard, the director was quite, seemed to be amenable to that. He had to worry about other counties that maybe would have other requests. But I felt good about the meeting, but there's nothing official yet.
All right, and just going back to then, what are some of the things that you're hearing from your constituents?
Well, as Representative Vander Linden mentioned, the things that we've already talked about. Additionally, I would mention the gas tax. That will never seems to go away, probably because the problem hasn't gone away. And do I expect anything to happen this year? No, I don't. Iowans have regularly opposed a gasoline tax increase. Having said that, I think there will be some new approaches to that problem this year. I know Senator Sinclair has a bill that would I don't know the details on it, but would take some of the general fund money and apply it to road use. I like that idea because as a state, we all know that the revenue has been good. We also know that state government, in terms of dollars, continues to grow, and it has year after year. I believe roads and bridges are a fundamental responsibility of government. We spend money on other things that I think are more questionable. And the point I'm driving at is that if we have general fund money that can be applied to the road problems that we allegedly have, that makes some good sense to me. I just don't want to keep growing government. That's the problem with just another higher tax.
Mm-hmm. And Mr. Vander Linden, what are your thoughts on a gas tax?
Well, I have opposed raising the gas tax as long as I've been in the legislature. I still oppose raising the gas tax. On the other hand, as the senator points out, I think it's pretty clear that we need to do something about roads and bridges. And I'm aware of the bill that Senator Sinclair has. There's another bill that's going to be introduced in the House that would take a very, very small slice of sales tax and apply it to the road use tax fund. And that's a viable possibility. My contention has always been that if fixing roads and bridges is a priority, then it's a priority over something else. And since we do have more money and overtaxation of Iowans on hand, it seems to me more logical to use that money to fix roads rather than increase taxes yet again on Iowans.
So when the session's all finished, what news stories do you anticipate will come from at the end of the legislative session that your constituents will read in the papers?
That's hard to predict, especially as one that's part of the minority party in the Senate. I think we've covered the ground of potential things that might happen. I can't predict those. I do believe, as a generally, that it's going to be a rather boring session as compared to last year. I also, because 125 of the 150 legislators that are there are running there will be an election for those seats, that there will be a desire to get out of town. I also predict that because there are some of those that are currently legislators running for higher office, there probably will be some grandstanding on their part to draw attention to whatever their aspirations are going forward, so.
And Mr. Vander Linden?
Politicians grandstanding, that's hard to imagine, isn't it? I can't really predict what might come up new, but I look forward to seeing what it'll be, and we'll deal with it as it comes.
All right, very good. Well, Senator Rozenboom and Representative Vander Linden, I appreciate you guys coming out here today.
Thanks, Aaron.
My pleasure, Aaron.